How important was the first home victory this weekend?
Yeah, look, I think it was important that we didn't perform very well against Rotherham in our first home game, so the lads were determined to put in a good show, and obviously the win was a real bonus in front of our own fans, who turned out in good numbers, actually. So, yeah, we're delighted.
Were you pleased with the performance, and did any individual player stand out for you?
Oh, look, I mean, we're always looking to improve our performances, but I think we got a lot of it right. It was one of them games that could have gone either way, and I'm sure Jersey were feeling quite a bit disappointed they didn't put us away first half when they had the opportunities, but we stuck in there and showed a great bit of tenacity. I thought our halfbacks were excellent. They put us in good positions territorial-wise. And, you know, we showed some great finishing ability. Obviously, Pritch and Tappers scoring a couple of good tries there. You know, it was nice to hang on in with Sharpie sort of putting the icing on the cake at the end.
What did you make of all three yellow cards?
Well, you know, the letter of the law. You just can't be doing things like that. Obviously, the Jersey first one, his legs came above the horizontal. Although I guess everyone would say it's slightly harsh because it was quite a high impact, high impact sort of collision. Mike Howard wasn't very bright, to be honest. And I think the last one was for kicking a ball out in an offside position, so it was pretty cynical. But yeah, it was quite a passionate game, and you know, these incidents happen, and you know, the referee probably got it right on all three occasions.
Are there certain areas that still need to be worked on ahead of this weekend?
Oh gosh, yeah, it never stops, and that's a good thing. I think, you know, we're growing slowly, we're getting lots right, but there's still elements of our game that we need to brush up on, and in particular our discipline. Again, you know, we spoke about having a good start, a good first 20 minutes, and you know, our discipline was poor, and you know, that's 3 weeks in a row, and we're giving it for the same penalty. So we're desperately disappointed without discipline, and you know, the lads got to wise up, because we can't afford to be giving sides a leg up early in the game. You know, it's all well and good coming back from points down and getting the victory, but before long, like London Scottish, you know, we'll leave ourselves with a mountain to climb, and we won't be able to claw that back. So, you know, there's some harsh words going to be said at training this week, and rightly so.
So this weekend sees a return to the B&I Cup. Will there be any changes made to the team?
Yeah, look, I think we're in a good place in certain positions, and these guys need to play. A couple of lads been out on loan at Amchill, and they can come back into the squad. You know, TJ Harris deserves a shot in the 22, and also then we've got Tom Williams and you know, Cam Camillo, who haven't played a lot of rugby, so they need to get out there and put a marker down. And to be honest, we've been really happy with the front five over the last few weeks. I thought they've been going really well, particularly at scrum time. But it's going to be a tough test down in Pirates, and we look to keep the core of the side together in key positions, and bringing guys around them, hopefully to have a real opportunity to you know, put the marker down for the future.
What are your aims for this season's cup competition?
Oh look, we always want to do well in this competition. We've had a couple of good runs in it, a final and a semi-final over the last 4 or 5 years, and we do enjoy it, going to different venues, albeit we've got Cornish Pirates and Doncaster in there, but it has a slightly different flavour to it. You know, bit of freshness about it. We're looking forward to Cross Keys coming a week Saturday as well, who we've not played since 1930, I believe. So that'll be you know, a nice spicy clash, given this Ladies' Day as well. And you know, but first up, Pirates, who are familiar foes to us, and we have some great games down there. It's going to be a humdinger of a game, because they obviously treat this competition quite serious themselves, given that they've got an even better record in this competition than we have. So I think both sides are running small squads, so you know, we've got what we got, and we'll get out there and make a good fist of it.
Are you confident that it's going to be 3 wins on the trot this weekend?
Well, look, I think what we've always spoke about is getting to a position where we expect performances, you know, and not hope for them. And we're going there slowly, well, getting there slowly. And, you know, again, we prepare well this week. Guys coming in should be hungry enough to add value to the group and provide a bit of enthusiasm and really take it to the next level from a week-to-week basis. So hopefully that'll be the case this week, and you know, if we're at the top of our game, then we hope to get a result out of it.